putting your masks to the test. Let's finally clear the air. What keeps you safe and what's clearly dangerous?
All the athletes wear these. So 60% nylon, 30% polyester, 91% hemp, 100% cotton, 100% polyurethane.
So many masks, so many types. They're everywhere.
A mask vending machine. Now I have literally seen it all.
And with so much out there, we want to know, do some masks work better than others?
How do you think this would do?
Not sure.
9 months into the pandemic, we still have no standards for consumer face masks. That's why we're buying more than 20 different types and taking them to the University of Toronto's Dalhousie School of Public Health. They're going to see how effective these masks are when it comes to seal and fit. They'll also test the material using the same standard for medical masks, like the N95.
The salty air is going to come out of here.
We know the coronavirus can be as small as 100 nanometers, about 1/1000th the width of a human hair. The test will measure how many of those tiny nanoparticles are getting through the mask.
We close the box.
Got it.
So we seal in all the air.
It's one of the toughest tests out there.
And then it all gets measured in the computer down there.
COVID spreads primarily through the air, attaching to the droplets you exhale. And as they become smaller aerosols, they can travel great distances. Now, notice with a mask how it slows or stops the spread of those particles, protecting others around you. But now new science shows masks can protect you too.
Do you, by wearing a mask, get enough of the virus in, you may have a mild infection, but you get some short-term immunity.
Monica Gandhi is an infectious disease expert at the University of California, San Francisco. She's on the forefront of this research.
Masks block a lot of the virus from getting in. So if by wearing a mask, you're more likely to get a less severe case, have a mild illness, not even have symptoms at all.
The hypothesis, masking leads to fewer deaths and more asymptomatic cases, but there's still lots of confusion out there.
The first thing that people ask me is, which mask should I wear? Should I do a surgical mask? Should I do a cloth mask? Should I do two? Should I do two, three ply? What should it be? And I genuinely don't know.
That's what we've asked the University of Toronto to find out. James Scott is a bioaerosols professor. He's overseeing our test.
Fair to say there were some surprises.
There were lots of surprises.
First up, this single-layer polyester GAITER mask.
What was the deal with this?
If you look at that fabric, it has very, very large pores in it. Air can simply sail straight through it.
Turns out this mask is not very effective at filtering out those tiny particles. These bandanas don't do so great either.
We actually tested a bunch of these masks. Anything about what these masks are made of that catches your eye in terms of being better than, say, something else?
They all kind of look the same, but sure. If I were to choose one, I guess I'd go for either the bandana or like this white one here.
I wouldn't use the bandana there. It seems like a very thin material, like a lot can actually go through that.
So happy you mentioned material. So this bandana, yes, super thin material, did not do very well. Same with the GAITER. Thinner weave didn't do so hot.
Wow.
Yeah.
Talk about learning something new every day.
Now, what about those valve masks?
Okay, so this is something you guys did to sort of illustrate the issue with the valve mask to us. And there it is. It's just sort of pouring out of there.
Why do we want everyone to wear masks? Well, we want everyone to wear masks because we want to reduce the potential
right.
for there to be this virus in the air. This doesn't do that at all.
We find it does a poor job of filtering particles and could even further spread infectious diseases. Health Canada warns not to use them, but seems not everyone is getting that message. Spotted in Ottawa, the Parliamentary Protection Service wearing valve masks. They tell us they're phasing them out, but many other places still offer them for sale without warnings. The masks that perform best? Disposable surgical type masks with non-woven polypropylene.
you can see no holes
yeah,
at all in that.
It's like a wall.
That fabric pulls out lots and lots of particles, far more than the other fabrics that we looked at.
And get this, a three-layer mask with non-woven polypropylene between two layers of cotton works as well as the gold standard, a medical N95. And it's way more comfortable.
That is remarkable.
It's certainly performed, honestly, almost as well as the awesome. N95.
Good to know. Perfect.
I'm looking at buying new masks. Now I know what to look for.
100% cotton masks, though, were an interesting story. These three-layer cotton masks didn't do so well, but these ones with only two layers did much better. What does Scott think is happening there? Well, when it comes to cotton, quality makes a big difference. The high thread count cotton masks we tested, 600 thread count and above, performed very well.
Higher thread count cotton, obviously when it's woven together, it has smaller and smaller and smaller pores. As air moves through, it needs to travel a circuitous pathway. And that's what's really responsible for trapping particles.
So there's more of a chance of those little coronavirus guys getting stuck on something like this, and even more of a chance if there's more than one layer of this.
Exactly.
Bottom line, look for masks with multiple layers, and the higher the thread count cotton, the better. But that can be tough to find out. It's probably not on the label because manufacturers don't have to put it there.
The higher the thread count, the better the job it does in terms of filtering out those potentially harmful particles.
Wow, that's interesting.
But that's not the most important thing when it comes to selecting a mask that's right for you.
Fit is the first thing. No matter how good the mask is, if it doesn't fit your face, then put it back.
There's barely any leakage coming from this mask. Now, check this out.
This is the unsealed mask.
If the mask doesn't fit your face, then air will simply move around rather than through the mask. If your glasses fog up, your mask doesn't fit very well.
See how it's sealed? Now watch this one.
Oh, wow. Oh. Yeah, there's smoke everywhere.
Oh, fog. Leakage.
Does any of this change what masks you guys might choose in the future?
Oh, absolutely. Well, it makes you think before you put one on.
If your glasses fog up, it's a sign that your fit over your nose is not tight enough.
So I think I need to change my mask.
I think you might, yeah.